I see Honorable Malema has raised his hand.
Thank you very much, Speaker. We are raising a simple matter that this cable tie, we took it from a security guy outside. And all of us should enjoy your protection. So a caring speaker who's concerned about all members of parliament and their safety would have immediately sanctioned that some brief investigation be made on the cable tie. And the second thing is that there are 21 policemen, subs, in white shirts. They came in here through police vehicles. The Constitutional Court has made clear pronouncements with regard to that. And if such an allegation is made, it will be correct for the Speaker to say, we sanction our table to ensure that indeed there is compliance with the law, as you say. It's not just an allegation. Our security and our safety is important, and it should be the concern of a caring speaker who's not partisan. So it shouldn't be a rumor because it came from an opposition. It is a serious issue raised by a member of parliament. And we need you as our head to assure us that no cable ties will be used against members of parliament, including injections. They are having injections. If there is a possibility of pushing people out here, people are going to be injected with biological weapons here, which are brought by these security people here. So please reassure us that we are indeed safe in this parliament. We'll raise our concerns and our issues without any fear or favor from the security apparatus. Thank you.
Honorable Malema, I have already ruled on that matter.
Honorable Malema, I have yet to rule on this motion.
Yeah, but you gave him an opportunity to speak before you even ruled on Godrich. Because the procedure is such that you must rule on Godrich before you give him. You broke your own rules, so allow me to proceed.
Proceed?
Yes. Thank you very much, Chairperson of the NCOP. Sitting in front of us here, it's a man who
is
incorrigible.
Are you on a point of order?
An incorrigible man, rotten to the core. And that has been found by the Constitutional Court. And this story that
Honorable
you voted,
Malema.
The story
Honorable
that you
Malema.
Voted majority to keep him, it doesn't make him
Honorable Malema, that is
president.
Not a point of order.
But listen to me. Listen
that
to me.
That is not a point of order.
But listen to me, Chairperson of the NCOP.
Yes, but that is not a point of order.
What
you
was,
stood
what
on
was,
a point of order.
What was Jackson's point? What was Jackson's point? What was Jackson's point?
Can I rule?
No, but let me speak. What was Jackson's point? We're all equal here. We're all equal here. Jackson did not rise on any point in the rules.
Point of order.
I'm following in what he did.
Point of order.
So I'm saying the fact that majority
point
voted
order,
against the Constitutional Court decision, it doesn't make the majority right. You voted against the Nkanda report, which was declared by the Constitutional Court that you were in breach of the Constitution by voting against the Nkanda report. You are repeating the same mistake. Mr. Zuma has collapsed his own right to address us here.
Can you allow
Mr.
us
President,
to rule on the matter?
441 soldiers will
order,
never
Chair.
Protect you.
Point of order.
Your
point
problem
order,
is not outside.
Point of order.
Your problem is here.
Point of order.
There is
point
no soldier
order.
Here. Here we are.
Honorable Malema.
You want soldiers to defend
Honorable
you.
Malema.
Let soldiers form a political party and
Honorable
come in.
Honorable Malema, please.
Inside here, they will never come in. So we are
Honorable
not going
Malema.
To allow the president
order,
to address
speaker.
Us.
Honorable Malema, please take
order.
Your seat. Honorable members, allow us to rule on this matter.
You are
Speaker, are suppressing our freedom
Speaker
of speech.
National Chair, please recognize us.
Premiers
and speakers
of
Can you please recognize us?
Provincial legislators.
Chairperson of the NCOP, you cannot allow a situation to continue like this. It's out of order. You have to listen to us. You must give us an opportunity to speak here.
Chairperson of the
Honorable Malema, just because you are standing for President of the ANC,
now
you are avoiding things.
Honorable members, we have been patient with you. We have been trying to give you an opportunity to express yourselves, but we believe that in actual fact, the freedom of expression of the members of this Honorable House is definitely being abused by yourselves. Because all honorable members who are here in this house have come to listen to the State of the Nation address. South Africans are here in the gallery. South Africans are sitting at home waiting eagerly to listen to the State of the Nation address. We would like to assure you, honorable members, that we will respect your freedom of speech.
Please do.
Your freedom to raise points of orders, but we are not going to allow you to obstruct the business of the House and to continue to abuse all of us on the basis that you have a right to raise points of orders. So we would like to say to yourselves, Honorable Shibamu, that we are not going to sit here the whole night listening to you raising points of orders.
But the rules allow
which we have ruled. We have ruled upon the issues you've been raising.
But you have not yet.
We have ruled and we are not intending to waste endless time because you have a right to raise a point of order.
Honorable Speaker, there is nowhere in this rule book where it's allowed that you will refuse a point of order that is raised by
Honorable Shibambo, you have not been recognized. Please take your seat.
I'm raising to be recognized on a point of order.
We have listened to numerous points of order from you.
It's allowed in terms of Rule 14S and 14U of the joint rules. Please recognize me on a point of
order. Honorable Shibambo, please take your seat.
And you're going to recognize me after I sit down.
Honorable Shibambu, please take your seat.
But I'm pleading with you that when I sit down, you're going to recognize me because I'm doing a legal and legitimate and constitutional practice of raising a point of order in terms of these rules.
Honorable
Can you
Shibambu,
please allow me
take
to
your
do
seat.
That?
Sir, you raised your hands.
No, but Honorable Chairperson of the NCOP, our chief whip raised his hand before the leader of the DA. The least you can do is to give him an opportunity to speak and then make a ruling. What type of criteria is this?
Give him chance to speak. Let us not have an attitude against members of parliament.
Nobody recognized you. Nobody gave you the space.
But let's give the chief whip of the EFF an opportunity to speak.
Honorable Malema, take your seat. There is an honorable member who is on the floor. Please proceed.
Speaker and Chairperson, I rise on Rule 14B. First of all, and this is absolutely critical, we saw earlier on today army members even here in the precinct. Hold on. The fact of the matter is that the constitution has been violated, which is something even P.W. Botha would have been proud of. The leader of the ANC who is here has violated the constitution. What doesn't change is the fact that South Africans voted for him. We are not here tonight to debate that question. What we are here tonight to debate is the people of South Africa and the fact that many don't have work. Can I request and prevail that we proceed on this matter so that we can talk about the people's business and the South Africans who are left behind while we have this discussion? Can I request that we debate that, please?
Thank you, sir.
On a point of order.
You rose on rule, joined rule 14B.
It's
14U. Honourable members, can we do the right thing and allow the president to proceed with his speech?
I don't want to interrupt the president.
Honourable members,
I've been raising my hand here.
Honourable members,
I've been doing the honourable thing, Chair.
We have heard points of orders which we have ruled on.
I'm speaking for the first time.
Honourable members, you will not hold the sitting to ransom.
I'm not trying to do
we
that.
We want
Chair.
To continue with the business.
Can
of
you
the
just
day.
Hear me out? Please?
Please take your seat.
Honourable House Chairperson, I'm rising on a point of order. It has nothing to do with what has been said.
What is your point of order?
Thank you very much. First of all, those two people there at the door don't belong in the house. Those two people there must leave the house. Give that order. Everybody that is in here must have this card and must have been sworn in terms of his oath of office. Those guys must leave the house. They don't belong in the house. They're in the bridge of the... Even the justices are sitting on the other side. We've got two people there. I don't know them. I didn't vet them. This is my house. They must leave. Those two people there. That's number one. I don't know them. Do you know them? You look shocked, Evie. But you say this is your house. There are two guys standing there. Who are they? Do they have this? They must go. That's the first point of order, Honorable Chairperson of the NCOP. The second thing is a fundamental mistake here. We are all first and foremost citizens of South Africa, and we are not allowed, according to the Constitution, to stand for any office if we have a criminal record. The Constitutional Court, it doesn't matter whether it's NCOP, it doesn't matter whether it's legislature, even a council of councillors in a township are not allowed to hold public office if they are found to have been in breach of the Constitution. If you want to listen to a person that has breached the Constitution, go do it elsewhere. Somewhere in the prisons there,
Honorable
where
Close,
criminals speak.
Make your
I have a
order.
Duty, together with other members of parliament who have taken an oath of office to protect
order.
This house in terms of the constitution. Mr. Zuma, please leave, Baba. Please leave. You don't belong here. You are a constitutional delinquent. You have to leave. Then we can proceed with the business of the house. I'm sure each and every one of us are competent to can deliberate on the state of the nation. But Mr. Zuma is a delinquent. He breached the constitution. It doesn't belong in you. It is him that should leave.
Honorable
Ngozi, you are wrong not to protect us. You're protecting him to stay here. As a constitutional, as a criminal.
You are not making a point of order.
It is a point of order.
It is no longer
How
a point
do you call this
order.
House in session
you are making
when
speech.
People have invaded? Mr. Zuma, together with those two guys, they don't belong in here.
Honorable
He's
Ndozi,
a criminal
please.
And
take
they
your
must
seat.
Leave.
Mm-hmm. Honorable Ndozi, take your seat. Honorable members.
Slalo. Slalo oga NCOP.
I want to rule on this matter.
Why manga bumute paramisi sanda ishoni paninga mvumeli? Ngiyacela njoba nami ngilanga imember lana.
In point of order, ma'am.
yabona lento point of order ngikhuluma ngithi ngiyacela
umuntu ucela on a point of order or point
yeah ngabe point of order ngaba kuyona ngifuna ukukhuluma
khuluma ma
ngiyabonga ke sihlalo lapho ngaphambili ngiyanibingelela onyakeni omusha nobabili kunento ebuhlungu la kufuke kuthiwa la njoba sila sizosebenzela abantu base South Africa akushiwo la ukuthi sizosebenzela abantu esibathanda nesingabafuni ngifuna ukwazi ukuthi njoba uhlezi lapho ngaphambili yini ukuthi masingena nikwazi ukusibona ukuthi sizolwa sibe singalo why nina nibone sengathi thina uma ngamela simthande ngishiso yini na ngisho ukuthi kuyimanje uma ngameli niyamazi
kunamacala
kodwa manje nibhizi niyamfikela
that is not a point of order
ahambe ohlale ekhaya akungena omunye kulesi asihlala
that's not a point of order please take your seat
and kuyimanje kuthiwa sizojova
Please take your seat.
Anendaba. Nimsakuba bona ubugebengu enibenzayo. We are sick and tired indaba
ubugebengu benu. Please take your seat. That's not a point of order.
Angikuzwa ukuthi uthini mina awusho kahle.
Honorable members.
Ngakutshela njalo
honorable member, please take your seat.
Uthini?
Please take your seat.
Angikuzwa.
Please take your seat.
Siyasinda lesihlalo ngizosithwala ekhanda.
Please take your seat.
Akodwa uyangichwenza ngikuthanda kanjena.
Please take your seat. Honorable members, we have been patient. We have listened to you. We have also said to you, you must refrain from these continuous points of orders, which are frankly very spurious. We have also advised that you should not abuse the joint rules. We want to ask you to take your seats, to allow us to continue with this business of this house. Or if honorable members are really not interested in the business of the day, please leave this house.
No.
I will not recognize any other point of order. I will not recognize any point of order.
You are making a terrible mistake. You are making a terrible mistake.
Honorable member, take your seat or leave this house.
The glue that binds the people of this country.
Honorable member, take your seat or leave this house.
Honorable chairperson, you are out of order yourself.
Honorable Madisha, I did not recognize you. Please take your seat.
You are not following the rules.
Please take your seat.
You are out of order yourself.
If you do not want to take your seat, sir, please leave this house.
Chairperson.
You have...
Chairperson,
take your seat or leave this
you
house.
You are wrong. You are wrong.
Honorable Madisha, please leave the house.
Because you cannot take.
Asha of
it's
the
wrong
Lord,
of you.
Honorable Madisha, to
it's
leave
wrong
house.
Of you to take. I want to emphasize what we believe is a thief from the streets and say that he must come and address a party.
Honorable members, I have asked Honorable Madisha to leave the house.
He has refused to leave the house. I am therefore calling on the protection services of Parliament to help Honorable Madisha to leave this house. Kwena, you are on your head, on your feet. You are recognized. Proceed.
Thanks, Chair. Just to reiterate, Chair, we've just seen that cable again now. So we need a clear undertaking from yourselves that this is not going to happen. We've just seen that cable. On a second point of order, Chair, I think the point that is been made here is that this entire gathering is unconstitutional, because in the first place, it should not be addressed by someone who has flouted his own oath of office.
Honorable
that is
Mukwena.
The point that is been made here. The entire gathering here
Honorable
is
Mukwena.
Unconstitutional. But can you please at least rule on the issue of
Honorable
the cable
Mukwena.
So that we can deal with that? Please,
Honorable Mukwena,
we're asking you.
The speaker has ruled on the first point you raised.
It's not, but the cable came inside here. The cable was in here just now.
Honorable Mukwena.
Can you please rule?
The speaker has ruled on that first point.
He has
Your
not
second
ruled,
point
sir,
is not a point of order.